Blackstone Audio presents The Miracle on Monhegan Island, a novel by Elizabeth Kelly. This book is read by Richard Powers. For Caitlin. I am His Highness' dog at Kew. Pray tell me, sir, whose dog are you? Alexander Pope. 1. May 1986. I disappeared from my life in the time it takes to buy a bottle of Yoo-hoo and a package of pork rinds. One moment, I was curled up in the back of a cream-colored Mercedes Ponton sedan, sleeping the bespoke slumber of those destined for high thread counts. The next moment, I was in an alien world of Naugahyde and errant springs, wondering what happened to all that buttery tan Italian leather. Even before fear, there's smell. And this old car smelled like a thousand nights without mornings. I hardly had time to suppress my gag reflex when that old beater squealed out of the convenience store parking lot, fishtailing onto the main drag, and throwing me from the back seat onto a musty floor upholstered in stale onion rings, empty soda cans, and mildew. "Go, go, get out of here!" The young guy who grabbed me was shouting, hot-footing it into the passenger seat, floor flung open, jerky momentum slamming it shut. Bouncing in his seat, head swiveling this way and that, he hollered for the woman behind the wheel to drive faster as she gunned it for the nearest highway exit, carping and chewing all the way, her fist pounding the steering wheel. Climbing back onto the seat, I huddled in the corner and focused on the backs of their heads. His hair swept the collar of his shirt in irregular black layers. Hers was a chemically tortured rack of what looked like lemon-yellow plastic fibers. He twisted in his seat, his profile visible, his skin white as snow. Insides madly spinning, my mind playing hopscotch, I was trying to beat back panic when, in a sudden surge of recall, they came to me. My father's instructions about hiding your fears. Don't turn them into an opportunity for others to exploit, or worse, enjoy. Oh, but too late. I was leaking terror, holes springing up everywhere. Already I could feel the winnowing effects of too much water and not enough oxygen. I started to pant. Snow White bounced around to face me. "Don't be scared," he said, leaning over the back of the seat, big grin, hand outstretched, fingers wriggling playfully. "I'm not going to hurt you." I had no reason to believe him, except that I wanted to, more than I had ever wanted anything, and with his bright complexion, high, broad cheeks, and wide, full mouth, he gave off a surprisingly mellow air of affability, creating an unexpected pocket of mildness amid the mayhem, a gently swinging hammock on a summer day, strung between before and after. Had he been a dog, he might have been a light-boned Landseer Newfoundland, black and white and friendly, improbably bordering on lovable, possessing a kind of elegant detachment. There was something about the eyes, though. They didn't match up. Ice blue and opaque, elliptical shape. This wasn't the brown-eyed family dog. He had cat's eyes. The only thing missing were the telltale bird feathers. "It's okay, Squirt," he said. "You're in good hands."
"You're nuts," the woman said. "What did you go and do that for? This is nuts. I don't need this, Spark."
"Relax," he said. "He's cute, right?"
"What are we going to do with him? Anybody ever tell you that you got a problem with impulse control?" she said, hoping to annoy him. But he laughed her off.
"You and me, old man, are going to get along great," he said. I had a feeling he'd earned the name Spark. As hard as she'd tried to engage him, he wouldn't fight with her, just smiled and poked and teased, her exasperation the accelerant. She kept getting more worked up, cheeks flushed and glowing. I wanted to let her know she was wasting her time, but it wouldn't have made any difference. She wasn't the brightest star in the night. We drove for hours. Dense greens on bleak, monotonous loop, the wind rushing noisily into the car's interior.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.